Jakub Szatkowski, you're watching Talking Dirt.
This is my apartment.
Yeah.
Oh! Fans from Slovenia!
You remember us screaming yesterday?
What do you want?
Know your secrets.
Which one?
All of them.
You understand?
Yeah.
Who's your money on Joe's?
Well, I think, you know, when you look at the World Championship, it's really up for grabs between two different riders, you know. You got Waguta with a very consistent advantage, and then you got Bartek there just ready to give everybody, you know, what he's got. So I'm looking for a really good 2 days of amazing speedway. In terms of tonight's race, I mean, this is Torun. This is the racetrack. It's the crown jewel. Every rider can really capitalize on tonight.
And your own riders?
Yeah, I think Ty and Freddie will be very strong. And everyone needs to watch out for a wild card Pavel over there, because he definitely knows which lines to run and which ones don't to run.
And he's a home track rider.
Yeah, and he'll get a little bit of love from that.
Can you explain what the box does that you attach to the bike?
This box is the RPM data logger, so receiving all the, when the bike is running, all the time the RPM on the engine. So after the race, I collect the data and analyze and see how many revs the bikes had during the race.
Okay, cool.
Them rocks hurt so much.
You should have been in the front. You'd have been alright then.
Well, I have been all night.
Yeah. Well, you've got two more to stay in the front. That will teach you, wouldn't it?
It will teach me. Man, the roof, my fingers were just popping it. One lap, I took my hand off the handlebars and was trying to get it out of the way of the straight.
So, Greg, what's your thoughts on how the season's gone?
Man, you know, you and I have had a few conversations over the year, and to look back on it now and your predictions, and you know, I think one of our earlier talks, I predicted that Magic, Artem, Ty, and Zmarzik were my top four guys, kind of in that order, in a sense, but. Maybe that hasn't worked out the same, but I feel pretty good that I made one prediction that was half decent, you know. And it's been intense, you know, to be in the same team with three of the four guys that I had a feeling were going to do well this year. And then you're in the team with them, and you're watching them develop. You're watching them make changes, tests, and feeding off each other. And then suddenly, you just felt like everything was going like this. Every time this one did well, this one wanted to do better, this one wanted to be even better, and it's just been amazing and fun to work with them. But there's been some surprises for sure, like there is every year, and some of the ones where you kind of expect probably it's not going to go that well, but I think it's been a great series, and the outcome is impressive.
What's your thoughts on the new Discovery takeover for 2022?
Man, well, everybody's kind of seen now, they've really thrown out the bait. And, you know, when they threw out the bait to me, I hooked on and like, wow, this is, it looks insane. You know, what they're going to do, what they're proposing they're going to do, and what's on the table, what's on the cards for me. It's, if I was a 16-year-old kid again, I would just be going, woohoo, game on, what are we going to do? I've got so many opportunities, so many dreams. Where do I start? I'm going to put the bar at an achievable goal, but I'm going to put it high. Hello, hi, hi there, how are you? Hi, buddy.
Hey, I'm Jamie Lidsey, and you're watching Talking Dirt.
So good to do your first Grand Prix, and wasn't expected.
Nah, for sure. I was sitting on the couch last night.
Yeah, unfortunately you're not in tonight. We have to take you out.
Okay. Nah, me and you, I might as well ride.
No, no, Martin Basu's just come back.
Yeah, he called me at 11 o'clock last night. Lucky I wasn't in bed yet, and yeah. I wasn't going to say no, was I?
The good thing is that the mechanic have the clean bikes.
Yeah, they've been clean for a couple of weeks now. They've been sitting in the workshop before tonight. The year was done, so hopefully I can finish the year off good.
Hey dude, how was your first Grand Prix?
Well, it didn't end the way I wanted it, you know, I only scored 1 point, but you know, at the end of the day, I'm racing against the 15 best guys in the world, so.
And you got called up this morning, or last night?
Yeah, but you know, you always want to do better than what you do sometimes, and you know, that's Speedway, and you know, got a bit to work on in the winter, and hopefully we can sort it out for next year and come back stronger. But now I know what to expect, and hopefully in the near future I'll be racing with these boys.
Is it giving you the inspiration to get to this level?
Yeah, for sure. I want to be, that's everyone's dream, to be race Grand Prix, and I want to be world champion. So as I said, there's a bit of work to do, but hopefully it'll be there sooner rather than later.
So dude, hasn't been the season that you wanted?
You reckon?
But you've had a couple of good races here in Torun in the last couple of days.
Yeah, a few races here and there, but you know, it's tough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's not going to be the last we see of you in the Grand Prix?
Definitely not.
You're going to come back stronger?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
When? I don't know, but I'll be more ready next time.
Cool. Going to go out with a bang? Deserving winner?
You know, without a doubt, that guy is a man on a mission. He was determined, and he wanted to win. You know, I have respect for that. Don't you want to win?
It was looking like, may have let the pressure get to him earlier, and the two wins in his last two rides.
When the going got tough, you know, he really got going, and he had to dig deep, and he, you know, it just showed that he wanted to be the world champion. And if you want to win, man, you got to dig deep, and you got to stay focused, and sometimes I wonder if he was just playing with us. You know, he's so headstrong, and watching what he did and the way he made that comeback after 3 points from three rides, it was just like the look in his eye is almost like, I had it all the time. Yeah, just amazing. I'm really happy for him. That kid's worked hard all year, strong in the head, fast bikes, and yeah, he's a world champ.
pig.
Mike Tyson.
Really appreciate your support over the years.
You guys have brought so much more to the sport. Without you, we couldn't take it where it's been. But more importantly, I think we've done four contracts.
Through 10 years.
Through the highs and the lows, and you've stayed with us. The last 2 years we're talking to, so we couldn't let it go. It's our last GP, but we wanted something that we could give you that was a bit special. So we've had this, we've commissioned this, and this is for you, mate.
Wow, what do we got here, fellas?
Do you know what it is yet?
What is that? Definitely a lid. A little brain bucket. Look at that, all our world champs.
Yeah.
All of them on the back.
And the calendar on the top where we've been when you've been with us.
Oh.
And your name?
Well, you know, there's some things I have to say. I would say I hate to be categorized as a sponsor. I feel I'm a partner. And what allows me to do what we do is these amazing fans we have in this sport. And your team and our team to be able to bring a show to those fans. Tonight, the fans won. The last 10 years, the fans won. And if the fans win, we win. So, thank you to everyone out there. But it's all about the fans. Get behind the fans. Come on. Come on out and have a good time.